It's Friday night here on a rainy day, but luckily we're inside for this CHL matchup between the Indian Hill Braves as they come to host the Finneytown Wildcats. I'm Grant Moranis alongside my father, David Moranis, here to bring you this one. We're ready for the tip. Hosmer will take the tip for the Braves, but Finneytown's Justin Anderson will come up with it, and Finneytown will start with the ball.
Looks like Braves come out in a man-to-man.
Eye on the athlete, John Griggs.
John Griggs, senior guard from Indian Hill, averaging 10.5 points per game, 75% from the line. He's averaging 4 assists a game coming off of a knee injury in football, and will test his defensive ability.
You talk about the keys to victory for Indian Hill. They've got to come out and start strong. They've got to get strong play from their youth, says Coach Birch. He says the juniors coming off the bench really need to step up, and they have to stay out of foul trouble because, honestly, their depth is not great. As Hosmer puts up a shot, fumbles around, gets the ball back, and he will get another opportunity.
Ill-advised shot. Braves are moving the ball well around the outside.
Schneider will pass to Nick Pye, will drive and put up a floater.
That's how you attack the boards right there.
And Kahn gets the put back. 2 points, Braves. For Finneytown, they need to utilize the quickness of their guards. Bally Butler, number 5, their point guard, is really quick. You see him there going on Zach Schneider, and Zach Schneider comes up with the steal. Up to Hosmer, who gets fouled and will head to the line for 2.
Braves start off with some good defense. Key to the game is to convert your free opportunities.
Last year at Finneytown, John Griggs matched up one-on-one on Bally Butler and just basically got owned. Butler's quickness just was no contest for John Griggs, and what ended up happening was Butler threw up a last-second buzzer beater to beat the Braves. Of course, when the Finneytown Wildcats came back here, the Braves put a good beating on them. Oh. Hosmer goes 0-2. Lane violation, however, so the Braves will get another opportunity to convert.
So important to convert those free throws, especially early in the game, establishing a lead.
And he can't get the roll. 0-3 from Hosmer.
Hopefully that won't come back to haunt them later.
Emmanuel Martin takes the ball off the court, gives to Butler.
Good switch.
Butler gets the ball back, gives a shot fake, and he'll now dish. That looked like a travel. No call, however. Finneytown still has not put up a shot in this possession.
Yeah, it looks like the defensive plan is to lay off at number 12.
And there it is, 23 puts up the shot. That's Derek Hudson off the mark. Griggs will get it. Shot fake, and they'll start it back up with Schneider on top.
There's a good look inside.
Schneider back out. He'll give to Pye, who will pop. Can't go. Finneytown quickly pushes down court.
It's a good job by the Braves to get back.
Butler going for himself, but Jordan Cotton with the big block. Fast break, Braves. Schneider will take it. Ball out of bounds off of Finneytown, so the Braves maintain possession.
Yeah, on that last defensive series, the Braves did a nice job of packing it in and getting back, stopping the ball.
Griggs from the corner, John Griggs. Now, John Griggs last year had a slow start.
Coverage of tonight's game on the Indian Hill.
He was 1 for his first 21 last season.
There's a big shot.
And a three-point basket to put Finneytown on the board. Griggs will take it up now. That 1-2 punch with Griggs and Schneider, their quickness really helps them.
Braves are doing a nice job of spreading the floor.
Off the mark there. Nelms to Martin off the mark, can't get it to go. Ball being kicked around, and Finneytown's Bally Butler will come up with it. Braves get the rebound and push forward. Schneider from behind the arc. Rattles in and out. Foul called. Looks like that'll be on number 5, Hosmer.
Not sure that's the shot they want to take in that possession. They've been doing a nice job of working the ball around in the possession. That was a little quick, I think, for Coach.
The junior Lucas Gould will check in for Jordan Kahn for the Braves. Martin will take it up the right side of the court. Nelms can't get it to go, rattles in and out. Braves push quick, and Schneider, the basket counts, and the foul.
Not sure that.
Pardon me, that was a charge.
That was a charge, they called it. I'm not sure the defense was set.
So no basket for Schneider there.
Braves are really keeping the defensive pressure up and extending it.
Nelms hits from the elbow. When I talked to Coach Birch this morning, that's one thing he really said. Two of the things he talked about was the talent of Bally Butler and the scoring power of Bradley Nelms.
That's a good look inside by Griggs.
Butler will travel on the up and down.
I think the Braves got the benefit of that call.
He rolled up on his toes, and we talk about John Griggs as he gets the ball here. His brother, Adam Griggs, is the coach for Finneytown, so a little brotherly matchup going on here tonight.
Griggs is really establishing the post on his smaller defender there. Made a nice pass.
Gould will lay it in.
I think the Braves will try to establish that on each offensive possession until they show they can stop it.
Working to Nelms. Nelms again from the elbow. Off the board and in. Tie ball game here with 2 minutes left in the first quarter. Griggs will drive, dish. Foul called. Chaos underneath. They'll call it on the floor. Braves ball.
Nelms really does a nice job of getting off the floor quickly, freeing himself up for shots on the other end.
Griggs finds Gould. Once again, Gould can't get it to go, and that's one of the things that Coach Birch was telling me about. He needs to see his senior step up. He says Lucas Gould works hard in practice, but a lot of times he just can't get that to go, as Nelms puts it off the board there. That's one thing that Gould needs to do is convert on those high percentage shots. And Hosmer for three. That is not really a Hosmer characteristic. He usually plays down low and works in the paint. So when you see him out there make a shot like that, that's just special. Stimely now checks in as Butler threw that one out of bounds to the Braves bench.
Now you got a minute 10 seconds left. You want to finish the quarter.
Little trouble in the backcourt. They need to hurry up and get it across, and they do. Depay finds Gould underneath. Can't get it to go. Back up. Can't get it to go.
Boy, they're missing some real golden opportunities underneath. Just got to take their time and finish those.
Butler, using his quickness, finds Stimley. Offensive foul called on the Wildcats, and the Braves will take over with 1 point lead with under a minute left.
Again, another opportunity to control the end of the quarter. Making some substitutions, keep some guys fresh.
Griggs checks out, and that's something you really don't see, which Coach Birch told me before the game. That's one thing that you're going to see, because the last 2 years, Griggs has not come off the court. He's played the entire game, and now with his knee, they're really trying to keep him healthy.
And it extends the timeout, give him an extra chance at the rest.
Nelms working the dribble. Nelms on the dribble drive. The foul called.
Yeah, you can't use your hands. You got beat to the baseline. You got to move your feet.
Now Hosmer will check out with his second foul. That's one thing that Hosmer needs to really start working on. And same thing last year. He's a great defensive player, very aggressive, but he gets in foul trouble. Jump ball there. Possession with the Braves. So with the last 10 ticks of the first quarter, the Braves will control. Griggs back in for Shea Boehner.
I thought that might have been an opportunity to get a call on an out of bounds instead of a jump ball. Finneytown player has a leg across the baseline there.
Snyder will push, gets it across. Out of bounds, knocked out of the hands of Griggs, but the Braves will keep it with them. 4.7 seconds.
See if they've got a play for end
of quarter. From the corner, off the mark. Butler at the end of the first quarter, Indian Hill leads by just one, 10-9. So, Dave, what do you think of the first quarter?
Well, it's the first time I've had a chance to see the Braves play today. I think they did a nice job of keeping the ball outside on the defensive end. They did not give the Finneytown Wildcats a real opportunity to get inside. I think the key as we move forward is the Braves have to take advantage. When they work the ball down onto the block, they've got to convert those bunnies.
We'll take a break right here. We'll be back.
Coverage of tonight's game on the Indian Hill Television Network is a presentation of the Indian Hill High School Video Department. The video department provides the community with educational and school-focused programming through the facilities of the ICRC.
Back here at Indian Hill Gymnasium for the second quarter of play. Once again, I'm Grant Moranis alongside David Moranis. Indian Hill holding on to a one-point lead. Finneytown will start with the ball. Martin on the dribble drive with the left hand up and off the glass and in.
A lot of confusion on that defensive set.
Braves working around the perimeter here. Try to get a look inside. Griggs wide open for three. Off the mark.
There's a nice pass underneath right there. Got to stay with it.
Nelms on a second attempt gets the foul call. He'll head to the line.
Did a nice job of cutting them off, but then they didn't stay with it after they got the block. I don't think we've seen a free throw made tonight yet, have we?
Number five, Butler.
I don't believe we have. You're right. And you talked about before, these freebies, you really need to convert or else it will come back to haunt you. Nelms finally converts from the line. Shea Boehner will check in for the Braves, another junior that will need to step up.
Finneytown out in a little pressure, 1-2-2.
Gould gets the rebound, puts it back up, out of bounds, will stay with the Braves.
That was a fortunate call. I think he's 0 for 5 underneath. He's really got to decide whether he's going to use the glass or step out another step.
Pye with the floater.
Braves stick with the man-to-man.
Griggs steps out on the double team. Butler will pass off.
Braves definitely have a size advantage.
Nelms from the elbow. Griggs getting a nice rebound over Stimley. Schneider for three. Off the back iron.
One and done. I think the Braves do a better job when they get into their set, move the ball, a few passes, get the shot they want.
After a little chaos, the Braves will take it. Schneider will bring it down, and he'll set it up from the top. Nice pass into Gould, and he will lay it up and in, the basket and the foul.
There you go, big fella.
Basket by Lucas Gould.
Let's see if he can convert his free throw.
He is fouled by number 12.
Braves really can't take advantage of their size. If they're patient, they work the ball around, they can get the ball in on the block. Clear size advantage.
Into the game for the Braves.
Speaking of size, Carl Koster enters the game.
Big opportunity here.
Can't get it to go.
Again, you'll see the Braves really do a nice job of keeping Finneytown on the perimeter.
Butler, circus shot off the mark, and Koster will get it, but a jump ball.
That's an awfully quick whistle. Braves need to keep moving that ball around, get it inside.
Griggs can't get it to go from behind the arc once again. And you talk about the Braves getting it inside, really need to start utilizing their 2 6-8 players in Koster and Gould. Some confusion, someone needs to pop out. Nick Pye finally gets control of the ball. Griggs will take on the dribble drive. He'll get it stripped by Martin. Martin will take it himself all the way coast to coast.
Yeah, I think that's a good call on the block. I'm not sure if I agree with it being on the shot. I think the call should have been on the floor. I think the Braves needed really settle down in their offense. They do a much better job of finding shots that work for them when they pass through the offense a few rotations. They really get out of sync and out of balance when they fire it up too quickly.
One of the keys to victory for the Finneytown Wildcats was to keep an up-tempo game, and if the Braves can do a good job of slowing it down and kind of lazying the Wildcats, they'll be better off on both offense and defense. Gibson, short on the three-point attempt. Butler pushes forward. Martin, the head fake. Down to Nelms, and the cut by Butler. Tries to dish, out of bounds. Braves
nice
basketball.
It's a nice drive. Again, the Braves do a nice job, really, of forcing forcing the ball out on the perimeter.
Snyder will take it with the right, going coast to coast, and puts up a little floater that gets nowhere, out of bounds, off the hand of Griggs.
There's got to be a call in there somewhere. It's either offense or defense. But when you have that kind of collision underneath the basket, there needs to be a call.
Butler for three. Gibson finally gets the rebound. Snyder will take it. Off the back iron, but 6'8 Coster comes up with it.
There's a big rebound. Let's see if we get the Braves to settle down.
Pye, a long three, and he scorches the net.
It's always nice when you make them, but I think they do a better job, and they have stand a better chance if they stay in their offensive sets.
Braves keeping the momentum here. Double team through the lane. Coster with the rebound, and the Braves will get the ball back. Snyder makes two of them miss. Dishes to Gibson, and he'll set it back up at the top, swinging it around the key.
As I said, I haven't seen the Braves much this year. I'm not sure what the depth of their bench is, but they got some guys who've been on that floor a long time. Their backcourt. And I think it's
Nelms.
Starting to show.
And the charge. Foul on Nelms, and that'll help a lot. Griggs will hobble off. And Birch will call a timeout. Not sure what happened, but Griggs got up and just walked off the court. Must be hurt or something. It didn't look like he was limping, so I don't think it was his knee. I'm not really sure.
He took a shot to the mid region. He definitely took off directly off the court.
Trainer Terry Conti dragged the garbage can behind Griggs.
Braves have done a nice job on the defensive glass, keeping Finneytown from getting many second chance opportunities. As I said earlier, they just really need to convert on the offensive end when they get it in close.
Griggs back in vision.
I think the Braves really need to establish and take advantage of their size. This is really an undersized, quick Finneytown team. Yeah, you don't want to pass that far across. You need to get that ball over there.
Gibson will work around, pick his dribble up a little quick there. Pye finds Hosmer. Snyder working the point. Spin move on Butler. Give to Hosmer on the drive. And Butler comes up with it for the Wildcats. And he will draw the foul that will send him to the line.
Yeah, I think Snyder tried to back off. And actually, it looked like he was able to avoid contact. And I think the referee anticipated contact and made the call without fully seeing it through.
Returning to the game for the Braves is Riggs, Kahn, and Gould.
A lot of substitutions. It looks like Finneytown's bench is pretty thin as well. I think they've been pretty much a six-man rotation, maybe seven.
Well, the Braves go with a nine-man rotation for the most part. primarily seniors start. And juniors come in to fill. But Birch said it's mostly a nine-man rotation. So a decent amount of depth on the Braves bench, but
again, it's always important you establish. You got 2 minutes about left in the first half. You want to win this two-minute segment. Go into the locker room with a lead.
It's all tied up right now. It's 17. Griggs on the dribble drive will take it. Can't get it to go, but Kahn on the putback off the glass.
Good follow. Braves do a nice job of crashing the boards.
And a circus shot. I'm not quite sure how that got in. But Emmanuel Martin seemed to put up a left-handed finger roll from the foul line. That was pretty incredible.
Another no call. And some bodies flying.
Pye will fade off. And Gould with another putback. You talked about Gould not quite being physical enough underneath and not getting those bunnies to go. I think in the past few minutes he's really upped his physicality.
Well, he's taking advantage of his size. They're going to have a tough time keeping him off the glass. A lot of it's anticipation, rotating to the right position on the floor. Got to make your free throws.
And it rattles around and falls.
You got a minute to go. They got a lockdown on D. And again, always thinking in segments. You win this last minute, maybe get another score.
Greg seems to be tripping around a little bit. And offensive foul called.
It's a good call by the ref. They're having a tendency to step out on that that high pick. Now's your chance. I don't think you want to rush this shot too early in the possession.
Gibson from the top of the key. The bank is open on Friday night.
Did he call that? They're going to check to see if it was a three, or they're giving him a three. They've extended the lead out. It's an opportunity to close out the half. Keep them off the scoreboard here and go in at up six.
Matt Hartman checked into the game for the Finneytowns. Finneytown doing a good job swinging it around. Puts up a shot with 3 seconds. Out of bounds, it'll stay with the Wildcats. Just enough time for one shot.
Good hustle by Gould there. Would have liked to have gotten that rebound off the glass, but nice job of getting after it. That's a five.
No call there. Nelms almost from half court.
That's a five.
So heading into the locker room, the Braves lead the Wildcats 25-19. We'll be back for the second half of action here on IHTN.
Let us know what you think of this sports production on the Indian Hill Television Network by calling our viewer feedback phone at 272-4590. Phone lines are open 24 hours a day, so give us a call and tell us how we're doing.
Well, welcome back to the second half. I'm Grant Moranis here with my dad, David Moranis. And the second half is got just underway. Two possessions per team, and Nick Pye drains from the corner.
Did a nice job of moving the ball around the perimeter to get that open shot. Braves stayed in that man-to-man. Now it looks like they're almost in a box and one. They're chasing one.
Martin.
I got to get somebody who can jump to get that ball out. Looks at him, shows him, that's how you do it. You actually got to jump.
Well, we saw Hosmer get up and warm up, so we know he's got the hops.
You can't dribble and pick up your dribble with your back to the basket like that.
Hosmer. Kahn on the offensive rebound. Finds Griggs behind the arc. Gets it to go.
Big rebound and good vision by Kahn on that one.
And the Braves come out with momentum here. They lead it by 10. I saw John Griggs. After he hit that shot, he looked right over at his brother on the Finneytown bench. They are pumped. Jordan Kahn doing great jobs off the board. Pulling down rebounds both on the offensive and defensive side.
Be interesting to see if they'll come out and stick with that man. Quickness from the Braves, you'd think they might be inclined to go to something else. But it's working for them so far.
Wildcats work the ball around to Nelms. Nelms on the dribble.
Yeah, that's a good call. This is an important part of the game for Finneytown. You don't want to get blown out here. This is a chance for the Braves to really put the clamps down, and Finneytown just needs to take their time and work through their offense and try and get on the board. Have we made a free throw?
Nelms hit one.
It's a lost start.
And Gould hit one too.
It's a lost start.
There's another one off the hands of Brad Stimley.
Oh.
Bad pass by Nick Pye. Stimley comes up, takes it himself, and can't get the layup to go. Braves push quickly down to the other side of the court. And they'll set it back up. Schneider working on the dribble.
Nice job of pulling it out, recognizing.
Hosmer. Hosmer's been putting up a lot of deep shots, and there he is. Back to his old self underneath the basket.
That's just good stick-to-itiveness. They stayed with it. Got a good bounce. Got an easy bucket.
Stick-to-itiveness. That's an interesting one.
That's back from the 80s. There's another no call on the floor. There's an opportunity.
Griggs laying up off the glass.
Thought he was going to dunk it like Brittany Griner. There's a chance. They got a chance to put their foot down now. A lot of dribbling. Nothing good happens when you dribble that much.
Well, there you go. Pye comes up with the steal.
Looks like the Braves' athleticism and size is really starting to wear out Finneytown here early in the second half.
Schneider on the dribble drive. Hosmer takes a shot from the elbow off the mark. A little pushing and shoving. But great hustle. Kahn will throw it off. Bally Butler and keep the ball with the Braves.
That's three plays here in the first 5 minutes of the second half that Kahn has really showed his value. If he can come off the bench and contribute.
Well, he started today, but last year he didn't really get too much playing time. And this year, showing Coach Birch, he should have been playing him. The Braves lost a lot of their team last year. The only returning starter is Griggs. Hosmer did play a lot off the bench. He was the sixth man. But Steve Bell, Austin Trout, Teddy Krimchek, Taylor Woodward are all gone. Brian Boone would come off the bench as well. Rodrigo Williams gets it to fall.
Not a lot of size on the floor for Finneytown, but they've got predominantly seniors. Looks like he forced that one.
Pass just slips past Nick Pye, but the Wildcats cannot get it in their paws and will give it up back to the Braves.
That's a big break. When you get out of rhythm, you start forcing things, and the offensive rotation isn't where it needs to be. Turn it over, and nothing good happens from it. Very fortunate.
Pye will drive and dish off the hands of a Wildcat. So, once again, staying with the Braves underneath their own basket.
Big man can't put the ball on the ground like that.
Gould can't control it there. Martin takes it himself. Finds Nelms.
The Braves guards do a nice job of moving their feet.
Another layup miss by Justin Anderson. I think that's the second or third tonight.
Now the Braves get a chance to take some time off the clock, work it around.
Nice pass inside to Gould. Blocked. Puts it back up. Can't get it to go, but he'll head to the line.
Does a nice job of following his shot. Beneficiary of his height. He's got to really learn to take his time, square up his shoulders, and get that ball to fall. There you go.
Gould will convert on the first attempt.
Braves have just a noticeable size advantage.
Can't get the second one. So one of two made by Gould. 23, Derek Hudson, the senior, for three. Boehner getting some time now for the Braves.
Doing a nice job of working it around.
There's a little confusion there, but Griggs ends up with it. Schneider from behind the arc. Shea Boehner with the rebound, and Finneytown will push it forward. Bally Butler, no good. And the Braves back the other way. Pushing hard to Schneider, puts up the floater, and gets it to rattle in.
Nice job, nice job. Thought he was going to get himself in trouble. He did a nice job of body control, floating that ball over the top.
Nelms taking the ball into his own hands. Griggs will settle now as he walks the ball up the court. About 35 seconds left here in the third quarter. The Braves leading it 38-27, trying to extend their 11-point lead. If the Braves can extend it a little bit further, we might see the likes of Pierce Arnold coming off the bench.
Too much dribbling. Too much dribbling.
Nelms takes it.
Timeout. There's a foul. That's his fourth. The number four. His first. Oh, first, yeah.
Shea Boehner for three. At the end of the third quarter, Indian Hill 38, Finneytown 29. Heading into the last stretch of the game, the last quarter of play, what would you like to see from the Braves?
Well, they need to really just continue to move the ball around, make sure that they don't rush their shots and get good shots on the block, finish their offense.
Very good. We'll see if that happens right after this. We'll be back for the last quarter of play here at Indian Hill.
Coverage of Brave sports on the Indian Hill Television Network wouldn't be possible without the generous support of the Indian Hill Boosters, the PTO, and the ICRC. Their grants have provided us with the equipment to bring Indian Hill sports off the field or gymnasium and into the community. And we appreciate all they've done to develop our television programming.
Back here, Indian Hill High School, as the Braves lead the Wildcats 38-29. Grant Moranis with David Moranis. As Finneytown works the ball around the perimeter, just doing a little motion handoff.
Braves will take that all night if they're gonna take time off the clock on their own.
Butler pushes, but Hosmer gets the rebound for the Braves, and Griggs will take it the other way. Number four, Nick Pye, works it in to Hosmer. Finds Griggs behind the arc again.
Big rebound there.
Nope. No go on that attempt.
Need to keep that same defensive pressure they had in the first.
Hudson will take his shot at it. Now a pass
big
off.
Big break.
There's and Hosmer break. Off the glass.
Good leave by Schneider. Set that up. Done a nice job distributing the ball.
Birch talked a lot about Schneider. He's the only junior starter with great court vision. Good quickness in the 1-2 punch of Schneider and Griggs. Can't get much better.
Gould dropped off and they got lucky there. Can't leave a shooter.
Griggs will try to take the attempt as Hudson trips over himself. Hudson will end up committing a foul on Griggs, and Griggs will have a seat.
Good job. If they can keep Griggs fresh, give him a blow, they're going to need him down the stretch.
Pie for three.
I think they're forcing some of these shots a little early in the rotation, starting to cost them.
And Butler with good body control to lay it in.
If Finneytown, you're where you want to be. You get it under 10.
Timeout called by Coach Birch.
Probably a good use of the time. He has to get Griggs back in there. The balance on the floor is much better when he's in.
The Braves had their big package in with Hosmer, Kahn, Gould.
They call that the jumbo package.
So as the Braves break the huddle, holding on to a 9-point lead over the Wildcats.
They keep their composure, keep moving the ball around. Again, their offense runs much better when they have multiple passes in a set. also works to wear down the defense. You can make them chase, get some open looks and knock them down. Finneytown's really going to have to step up the defensive pressure. I don't think they could sit back. There's a good pass.
And Kahn will lay it up and in. Once again, the good vision like you talked about from Zach Schneider.
That's good help side right there.
Nelms looking for an opportunity, can't get it, but Stimley, no go. Hosmer.
Now they need to pull this ball back out. Take a little time off the clock.
And that's exactly what they'll do. Pye trying to get it into Hosmer, but Butler will take it from him.
Hosmer's got to come in established position and come get that ball. He waited back for it.
And the charge called, the offensive foul on Emmanuel Martin.
Not sure I saw that one.
Yeah, that looked like a pretty clean play there.
Teardrop. That's just fortuitous because that's, again, I don't think that's what coach is looking for. Up nine.
The Braves really need to use some clock here. Make sure Finneytown doesn't get a great opportunity to come back. I mean, it is only a three-possession game.
Well, the longer they go in their possessions, the more success they've had. They tend to break down somewhere. There's another example.
Unfortunately, can't get that one to go. Hosmer back up. Connell rattle around in a jump ball. Nice hustle.
Good hustle by Conn. May have gotten away over the back. But if you watch, when they make it go deep into the rotation, They've been getting good opportunities.
Hosmer. Oh, almost a good putback by Griggs. Griggs called for the foul.
Hill, number two, John Griggs. His second, team's third.
Yeah, there's another example. I don't think they needed either of those shots. Again, up nine. They're giving the Wildcats an awful lot of opportunities to get themselves back in this game. Carried, yep. It's been a pretty well officiated game. They really haven't been too involved.
Griggs looking for the foul call but can't get it. I gotta be honest, that was a weak attempt at a flop there from Griggs. Good no call.
You gotta get the ball in the hands of the guards.
In the hands of Griggs now, will give it to Pye from the corner. And Butler will get the rebound, dish off to Hudson, and the foul called.
That's okay. He had to stop ball. If you're going to make that foul, though, you don't want him to get it off, get the shot off. That's two possessions in a row. They've really put up a shot. There were several shots that they probably could have done without too early. Part of running your sets is it sets your defense and it sets your rebounding. And you shoot out of rotation, the balance is off. Makes it a lot easier on the defense.
Hudson can't convert on either of his attempts, so a good foul there turns out to be. Bad pass there from Nick Pye. Nelms finger roll, and the put back from Martin.
Basket by number three, Martin.
Timeout called now. And Birch is not happy.
He's not happy. They're just seem to play it a little lackadaisical there. You got the lead. You got to take care of the ball. Again, every series they've really worked the ball around. They've got an outmanned Finneytown squad. They've been working the ball around. You can watch through the possession. They tend to break down sooner or later. We've had good shots when they force it or go early in the possession. They've struggled. And if it wasn't for some missed free throws by Finneytown giving them back, so to speak, this would be a lot tighter ball game. They're going to put some pressure on them now.
Absolutely. Finneytown working the press. Braves quickly get across half court and will set up their offense.
They're up 9 points. The way I look at it is you don't even have to score again.
Well, I'm sure they're going to be looking for a double-digit lead.
Wow, another unforced error.
Braves really getting sloppy on their passes.
Coach was looking for a call there.
Martin, the circus shot, not even close.
Now's the time you gotta just bring it back out.
Foul called on Butler.
Here we go down the stretch. We have about just over 2 minutes left. We're going to see if they can make their free throws.
Pye works it into Griggs.
Might have got away with a little elbow swing.
Griggs is an aggressive player like that. When he gets angry, he can get a little dirty. Butler takes it. And we'll call a timeout for Finneytown. Lead surely getting smaller and smaller.
You gotta
give
them credit, they haven't given up. They keep fighting, they keep scrapping.
Down only seven now.
Braves let them right back in it. You always got to look at those two-minute segments. You want to win every segment. You can put back enough of those, and you win the ball game at the end. What do they say? If you score more points, you win?
Yep, that's usually how it works.
The team that puts the ball in the basket wins. That's not whose hand you want it in.
Another sloppy pass from the point guard.
Really
Schneider.
They're in too big of a hurry, as I said earlier.
There's under 2 minutes in this game, and Butler will cut the lead to five now. And now this one's getting a little interesting. Braves having trouble working it across the court.
Timeout.
It's a timeout, Braves.
Good call by coach over there. Yeah, nobody was coming to help, but you also can't pick up your dribble like he did. It really gets you in trouble. You got to keep your dribble at all times. You know, back it out if you have to. Possession arrows with Finneytown. So Braves got to do a good job of taking care of the ball.
Pye will
need some help. You got to really work. Two guys need to work together here.
Pye will inbound and the foul called on Hudson.
I'd like to see him to work in tandem. Have both guards working off each other. Have a pick.
Griggs will take it himself, but then dish to Hosmer. Hosmer having trouble. And a foul called. Coach Griggs not happy.
You got three guards on the floor. And you rotate the ball over to a forward. It's not what you need to be doing.
Well, the foul will put Finneytown into bonus, and Hosmer.
There's those free throws we talked about earlier. Got to make them down the stretch.
Sinks the first one of the 1-1 attempt.
Now this one's a big one because it make it a three possession game again.
Can't get it to go, but something called.
On Pye over the back?
No, they called.
Wow.
Called on Finneytown, so Hosmer.
A lane violation. No?
I don't think so.
The ball was away.
Hosmer heads back to the line.
That must have been a line violation.
So, in the end, he gets both parts now with a few ticks over a minute left, and Griggs comes up with the steal. He'll get the basket and the foul, and he is pumped up.
That's the way the senior leadership steps up as you go down the stretch.
An intentional foul called.
So he's going to get the shots and the ball.
Shots and the ball. He's got two shots from the line.
I think the question was whether he gets and one, and then he gets two additional and the ball.
He will sink the first one.
So they're only giving him two shots, the basket plus two shots, plus the ball.
And he'll sink 2 of 2, and that's one thing that Griggs doesn't struggle with. He's 75% coming into this game on free throw attempts. And he'll sink both of them there. And the Braves, with 1 second over a minute, will get the ball back. Schneider with the left. Gould with the rebound and the putback.
Puts it back again. I'm not sure that's the shot they need to be taking, but I guess if you're going to attack the rim, you got the height advantage. Finneytown's not even getting a shot up, so.
Finally one there, but can't get it to fall, and Pye will get it. Foul on Butler.
I think Finneytown ran out of gas. You can tell they were really pushing them and snuck their way back into game. Creeped, I think, got as close as 6 points, and just ran out of gas.
Nick Pye can't get it to go, but off the foot of Nelms, and the Braves will get the ball back. John Margraff will see his first action of today's game.
Now they're going to make Finneytown chase them. They got a foul, unless they've conceded at this point.
Well, they're not going to foul. Shot put up for three, an air ball, but Hosmer with the putback.
Margraff got himself in the books.
And this game is over. The Indian Hill Braves take their home opener and keep themselves undefeated 3-0. The Braves take it from the Finneytown Wildcats 52-37. Dad, how was your first time announcing?
Oh, it's interesting. It's a team here that we watched. It's got a lot of potential. Again, they got a lot of good size. As they move forward, I'm sure they'll work on working those folks into the game. And just an up-man Finneytown team.
I'm here with John Griggs after the game. John, you played a great game. How do you think your team did today?
I felt like we did really good on defense with our effort and intensity. Maybe the offense wasn't there, but as long as we keep holding teams under 40 points a game, we'll be a hard team to beat this year.
Now, you had some time off the court. That's something that you're not really used to. How does that compare to playing the past few years when you played every minute?
It was all right. The only reason why I'm out right now is just because I started practicing a few weeks ago, so my wind isn't there all the way. So I have to keep that going so we can keep having a good year.
I got to ask your brother on the coaching side for Finneytown. You going to talk to him tonight?
Yeah, we're going to talk after the game a little bit. There aren't any hard feelings. We don't talk any smack or anything because usually whenever like we try to talk smack, the other person ends up winning by a lot. So we'll keep it clean.
All right, well, good job tonight. Go celebrate with the team.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Your final thoughts on tonight's game?
Well, I thought for first home game, they did a nice job. As John said, they played aggressive. They played hard. They didn't quit. And, I think they got things to build on, and should be a good season ahead.
Well, there you have it. Braves pull away with the win over the Finneytown Wildcats. We'll see you next time on IHTN. So long, everyone.